It is arguably the most talked about and most despised tax ever proposed in British Columbia. And today, a former premier brought his fight to stop the harmonized sales tax to the door of Premier Gordon Campbell. And he's not alone. ANews reporter Louise Hartland has the story. She joins us live with more. Louise.
Hudson, as the anti-HST movement ramps up on Vancouver Island, you can expect a knock on your door and a lot of noise in the coming months.
No!
Anti-harmonized sales tax or HST rallies like this are becoming commonplace around the province. Today, the fight against the contentious tax took a turn. Former Premier Bill VanderZam is heading up a petition to drop the HST. He's got just 90 days to get it done.
So we've got an army ready to go to work today. They'll all be getting the petitions during the course of the day, and they'll start taking signatures, some today, some tomorrow, and it'll go gangbusters for the next month.
To do that, support is needed from more than 10% of registered voters in each electoral district around the province, something many are skeptical of. Thousands of volunteers are hitting the streets, going door to door to collect signatures in hopes of stopping the tax.
Well, I think it's highly unlikely. It's a very difficult enterprise. You've got to organize troops on the ground to go door to door, and 10% in each riding, that's a lot of signatures.
Good morning, Elections BC.
Elections BC says that number tops 300,000.
I think if you look in terms of total signatures, it's going to be around 300,000, but they need to get the 10% in each district. So that means if they're over in one and under in another, then the petition's going to fail, and it only has to fail in one district for it to fail overall.
If the petition successfully collects all of the signatures, there's no guarantee the tax will be stopped.
Just like any other bill, there's no guarantee of passage once it gets onto the floor of the House.
The anti-HST movement is gaining momentum at the grassroots level too. Josh Steffler is organizing a rally tonight at the legislature to raise awareness for the petition.
I don't think it'll be a problem to get 10% in every riding. I think we'll probably get upwards to like 30%, 40% each riding.
With the campaign just ramping up, expect to see more of this in the next 90 days. Hudson, the petition needs to be signed in person and in ink. That means if you've joined one online, it doesn't count. And also, if the HST does pass, it may not stay at 12%. Today, Nova Scotia upped their tax from 13% to 15%, making it the highest in Canada.
Ouch. All right. Louise Hartland reporting. Louise, thank you.